This video is proudly brought to you by Hovatek. Hovatek. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to back up a Mediatek Android phone using Miraclebox. Now, the first thing you'd want to do is to make sure you have your Mediatek USB VCOM drivers here, and of course your Miraclebox. Now, I'd dropped a guide on how to read back using SP Flash tool. You can check that out, but this is a much easier method. Now, the first thing you want to do is to install your Mediatek USB VCOM drivers. Now, these drivers help Miraclebox communicate with your phone, so it's very important to install these drivers. Now, the first thing you want to do is to launch your device manager. Alright. I want to install the drivers. Now, in device manager, you tick any item. Now, don't forget, if you're using a Windows 8 or 10 PC, it's very important to disable signature verification. We have a guide at the Hovatek Forum on how to disable signature verification on a Windows 8 or 10 PC. So just see that guide to disable that, because this driver you're about to install is an unsigned driver, and if you don't disable that, you will not be able to install it. All right. So now you tick any item back to device manager. You tick any item, then you click on action, add legacy hardware, next, install, next, hard disk. Browse. Now you navigate to location of VCOM drivers. This is where I have mine. Here. Now don't forget to disable your antivirus when using Miraclebox. I had to disable mine. That's why you can see those prompts. I had to disable mine because your antivirus might see Miraclebox as a malware. It's very important to disable your antivirus when it's in Miraclebox. All right, so back to this. I clicked on browse and I selected this, and I forgot to explain something here. Now I'm using a Windows 10 PC, and you can see from here I cannot find Windows 10, so I'm going to use the Windows 7, same for Windows 8. All right, you can use the Windows 7 driver. Now this is for 32, this is for 64 bits, so it's very important you know your PC's architecture. Now to find out that, you go to my computer, you click on properties, and then it appears mine is a 64-bit PC, so I'm going to be selecting the 64-bit version. Open. Okay, next. So I stand by. All right, the following hardware was installed: Mediatek.USB VCOM port, and you can see I have a code 10 error. This is nothing to worry about. The reason why you are getting this error is because you installed an unsigned driver. All right, so it's nothing to worry about. Now you might also see some yellow triangles here. It's also nothing to worry about. The reason why you are seeing these is because you have installed an unsigned driver, and Windows thinks it might not work, but it doesn't mean it's not going to work. But I assure you, if you follow this guide, it's definitely going to work. All right, so I've installed drivers. Next thing is Miraclebox. All right, so I open the Miraclebox folder and I launch it. It might take a bit to come up, so you have to be patient here. All right, so Miraclebox is up, and now the first thing you want to do Miraclebox here is to click on MTK. Since you are backing up an MTK Mediatek Android phone, after clicking on MTK, you want to make sure read is ticked, since I'll be backing up. Now you want to select the chipset type for your phone. I will be selecting this MT65XX. That is my phone's chipset. Now at this point you have two options. Okay, you can choose to back up as scatter format, that is SP Flash 2 format, or you back up the entire firmware as a bin file. All right, now if you want to backup as in an SP flash 2 format so that you can flash it in SP flash 2. What you want to do is to click on save as scatter file. All right, I'll still be showing the other method, but I just want to show you this quickly. This is the scatter method. All right, so you click on save as scatter file, you click on start button. Click on the start button. Now you can see waiting for USB port. At this point, the switch off the phone, still with battery inside, and then you connect the cord. You connect it via USB cord. Now do not press anything, just stand by. Now next thing you do is next thing that will happen is you get this box here asking you to select what blocks you wish to back up. Now I will be backing up. You can just stick everything if you want, but I'll be backing up just boot, just to make this faster. All right, I'll be backing up just boot because I'm still going to show you the bin method. All right, so I'm backing up just boot. You want a full backup, you tick everything. All right, so I click on OK. Now I will select the location where I want the file to be saved. I think I'm okay with this. Not here. I think I'm okay with this. Let's try this. All right, so you have something like this now. So once that is done, you have the done message. So what you need to do, just go back to the place, the folder where you selected, and you should see it backed up. Now you might see it in the .bin format. You might see it in the .bin format. You might see it in the .bin format. Alright. So what you want to do here is, if you want to flash an SP flash to, just rename from .bin to .img, and you can go ahead, alright, to flash an SP flash to, but I will not be doing that. Alright, so back to this folder. Now for the second method, that is when you back up the entire firmware as a .bin file. Alright, for the second method, you will not tick save as scatter file. Alright, so I'll be unticking this save as scatter file, and then I'll disconnect the phone, still leaving it switched off with battery inside, and then I click on the start button. Alright, next I connect. Now I'm going to get a prompt asking to select where you want to save the firmware to. Alright, so I can just select this folder to save this firmware. Now it's going to be in .bin format, so I just click on save, and then it starts. Now this process can take quite some time, so you really have to be patient, and it's very important you do not disconnect the USB cord at this point. So you can see that still backing up in the .bin format. So I'll just wait for a few seconds for it to start backing up, for it to at least see that it is loading. It's going to take quite a long time, and I will not be waiting till that happens. All right, so I'll be waiting for 1%. Could take quite some time depending on the kind of phone you are backing up, so do not disconnect, do not interrupt. If for some reason the USB cord gets disconnected by accident, you just have to restart the process. If it can't detect your phone, you take out the battery and reset. Right, I have my 1%. So you just have to be patient till it gets. You have to be patient till it gets to 100%, and then you see a done message. It should look something like this. Yes, it should look something like this. So once you see this, that means backup is complete. You can disconnect the phone, and then you boot up and then locate your firmware on your PC. All right. So that is how to back up a Mediatek Android phone using Miracle Box.